Now here's something else you can try to strengthen your back when you start feeling like it, like about now. I'm not 100% just yet, but you can get up here, put your feet up here, and go over sideways like that. Try to keep your knees together, you know, the same here, on top of each other, your feet, and then just put your arm back here and try to stretch, you know. And try to keep your knees on the ground. Keep your knee on the ground if you can. And just try to pull over here and stretch a little bit. You're going to feel it in here. What you want to do is try to get that pressure off of your back here. Kind of like you're breathing it, letting it breathe. You want to get distance away from the affected area, okay? I'm just trying to stretch out here to the right as much as I can. I'm feeling it right in there. Give it a nice stretch. You don't want to overdo it. Once you start feeling it, you can't get your knees all the way down there. If you can't get them together, try the best you can. And if you can only do a little bit, you don't want to do too much, okay? Last thing you want to do is overdo it and retweak your back to try to prove a point or something, you know? Back and forth you go. Where she stops, nobody knows. So try that as well. Let's go in the other room. I got something else I wanted to show you very quickly. You got to ice your back. I mean, once you tweak your back, you don't want to take a hot bath or anything like that. You want to get some ice on there, and you've got to use a gel pack. And if you don't have a gel pack, or if you don't want to go down and spend the time to go buy a gel pack and all that kind of stuff, you can make a gel pack. And that's what my mother did for me. She made me a couple gel packs, and she just put them in some bags. And how did she make that? That's what you want to know, right? Ziploc bags. She put it in two Ziploc bags. This is a gallon bag and a quart bag. And she mixed up. Now this looks kind of icy, and it's been sitting in there for quite a while now, a few days now. And see, it's very pliable, and you can kind of break it up a little bit. And she made this out of rubbing alcohol and water. Three parts water to one part rubbing alcohol. That's it. That's all she had to do. And then you can put that on your back. You get a different type of back brace here. See, I've already got, let's see here, get you situated here. I've already got my nice flexible one on here because there's not enough room to put that underneath this flexible one because it's so tight. I guess if you had enough room, you could put this on first, but I don't. And so I got a bigger one here with some ribs on it and stuff. Okay. And somehow, I mean, you just have to kind of hold it in there and put it right where you need it on your back and then wrap this around and have that cold on there. I mean, I could double bag it again, and I made, my mom made three of these, and now I have smaller ones for other things, see? Now I can let that sit on there, and I can go about my business for a few hours, okay? Then I can take it off, and then I can wait for a while and put another one on. That's the beauty of these things. What you want to do for your back is when you have an issue like that, you want to put cold on it and then you want to take it off. And it's kind of like putting heat. You're not really putting much heat on it for the first few days. Cold, then kind of lukewarm or warm. Cold, warm, cold, cold, warm. And what that's doing is contracting your muscles. First you're expanding them, then you're contracting them when you're getting when you're using the ice packs, okay? Now this ice pack is only going to last for a while, and then it will, once it melts, it'll almost be like water again. Okay, then you throw it back in the freezer and you get ready to do it again. Okay, that is a must. Well, here's that inverter table I was telling you about, and I got just enough time to do this. I wanted to show this on the video. And so you put your feet in here, and then there's a little push button here that you can put it down, push on it, and lift it up. Well, if you're going to have a bad back, you might want this so that you can still pull your feet out. You know, you don't have to have it perfectly tight, because the first time I got in this thing, I couldn't then reach down to depress this and I couldn't get out. It was terrible. So don't let that happen to you. Okay, I'll show you how this works right after this. Okay, so when you get in this, you just have to be careful, hang on to this. Put your feet in there sideways. And then just lean back, and it goes back. You don't even have to really push on this very much. You can just pull your hands back like this, and it goes back. Woohoo! Oh, yeah. That feels good. It's off, all the weight is off of your back. You see all of your upper body is pulling off of your lower back, and you can sit here and you can just start sleeping, or you can be flat like this. You know, that's right about here is where you start feeling that pressure come off of your back. Oh, it's wonderful. So if you have a bad back, you can get one of these inverter tables. I don't know how much they cost nowadays. Maybe you got a friend who's got one. Maybe you can borrow it and they can bring it over and put it in your garage or something, or your spare room or whatever. You know, once you're down here, you can hold your arms back here and just go to sleep. And just don't concentrate on anything other than your breathing. You know, and feel it right there in your back. And you can do that for a half hour if you want, or more, whatever. Then you've got to pull yourself up gently like this. And see, when you have a bad back, you're not even going to be able to raise up like that to get down to there. So you can be right here, scrunch down a little bit, slide your foot out, you know, and just be careful. Grab your little cane. I left that at home. But you can use that and then gently get out of here. Okay? Yeah, it works great. I've got my second brace on. I've got the first one on. And here's that ice pack that I had. It's already starting to melt, but even with it melted, it's still going to be nice and cold. Stick it down in there. And if you're sitting at a computer like this, or if you're sitting down a lot, the last thing you want to do when you have a bad back is to sit too long in a chair. Okay? Every once in a while, get back up out of the chair, walk around, do some walking, or whatever, do some stretches, do something, because then that's gonna start tightening it up again, okay? Now, even though my back really doesn't feel that bad anymore, I'm still gonna take note and try to be careful as I'm working and still do some walking, do some riding on my bike, and keep the ice pack on every once in a while, take my pills, do all kinds of stuff, because I'm preventing anything from happening again. I want to make sure I get 100%, so this next week I'm still going to do all the types of things that I was showing you. I'm also going to do my exercises, pulling my feet up, you know, when I get ready to sleep, or if I just want to take a little break, I'll lay on the carpet and pull my feet up and do that, do some stretches back and forth. Anything I can do to help my back get 100%. Okay? Follow some of these tips and see if it doesn't help.